nice a Friday, babe. LOL. Oh, well, we finally made it through the week, people. This week was, it was something. We had so much going on. We had the whole Miss Cavi. We had the whole ambassadorial thing going on with Miss Tourism. It sparks off way too many conversations. And as we're still resting from that, Dora Mwima comes and throws us a curve. Aish, before that, we had to celebrate and commemorate the Let Radio's birthday. Like, it's been action-packed. And we can wait for demo ne kamilio ninga yes chance. Oh, by the way, for all of you who don't know, yes, Yamala Nabite Gerambu Biakola Biambo is actually going to perform. This week has been lit. It has been lit. I pray next week is this lit though. Anyhow, it's a Friday, babe. And I'm psyched, I'm pumped. It's Scoop and Scoop. My name is Tina Fierce One. Welcome. Now, of course, because it's a Friday, don't forget to get yourself a copy of the Kampala Sun in case you haven't yet perused through it. Aha! Jesus! Let's pass through what they say. One of the biggest headlines is, I don't care about Mwima's son. Now, Radio's mom apparently said, yo, check this out. We are dealing with so much, so much. She won't be the first person to come out and claim my son has a child with her. Like, you remember the first two people, the one who had a girl, the one who they called Tracy Nachibogo, and then the other one. There were two females. They told them, okay, it's fine. If you say they're our children, kawa, mujetu bakole DNA. Vanished into thin air. No one knows about their whereabouts. And of course, they talked to Frank Sechibogo, that is, of course, the Let Radio's brother. And he also said the same, man, we don't care, we don't care. I mean, baba wafe amulete, tukole DNA, tugene maso. As in, tebagala manya. Then when they asked Wizo, Wizo was like, yo, I am facing enough challenges to begin dealing with this ish right here. So whether they knew each other or didn't know each other is none of my business. My brother was my brother, and who he slept with wasn't my concern, because I sleep with my own people. Uganda Zabu. Anyway, that's all in the Kampala side. And then they have the death march. They're talking about Kasiria Gwanga Kusasira Shoot to Kill in the grill. And this is something that actually interested me. Haven't you guys of jazz lovers? Haven't you jazz lovers, acoustic lovers? If you've been on the scene in Kampala, you all know the main man to go to is Shaka Mayanja. Now, Shaka Mayanja is like the it guy. When international artists want to come here, he's the guy who bridges that gap. Like, he's known like that. He's acclaimed like that. But they asked him, boss, when are you getting married? And he said he's waiting for his ancestors to tell him, to let him get married. I'm like, man, you know what? At times the weed we smoke is way stronger than they tell us. This is not normal weed. This is sour manila. Anyway, all of that is in the Kampala side. Everybody has their own take. Now, another story that killed me. Now, you know how we've been dealing with Minister Chiwanda's situation and the curvy girls. Now, Kampala-san has done an issue. They've done a pullout, and they're saying big size no more. And it has three most reputable, chubby, chunky, beautiful ladies that we've come to know and love with time. Straka Mwezi, Shamim Biencha, and actually there's this one of NRM, Kasule Lumumba. Man, I'm looking at their before and after photos. They done lost so much weight. So what are they going to do? We are looking for tourist attractions. These ones are here losing weight. I don't know if they're doing it to be healthy or to fit in with the normal society, but I'm like, you know what? It takes a certain type of discipline for you to reach. Straka is looking like a snack. Jesus. It's just, she still has a bad thing for having good hair. Like, her hair game has always been weird. I'm spotting this guy hair, and I'm like, the hell is going on here? But anyway, Chiwanda likes his tourist attractions, curvy. It acts very many people. That and a lot much more is in your Kampala Sun. Get yourself a copy. And remember, you cannot not read it alone. Let us delve into things that were exciting for me. So here's the thing. Y'all know Shonga, right? The Shongas. Herbert Shonga and his chick, right? Last time I checked, they had broken up, made up, Now I'm hearing they've broken up again and he's with Sasha Brighton. I'm like, wait, what? Wait, pause, pause. While important things were going on, the fornication was still on the back. Anyway, that's not the reason. It's not about fornication. I mean, he's Herbert Songa. What do you expect from a fuck boy? Seriously. Anywho, reason and things are coming out. Mbu, he is actually very broke. He is not normal broke. He is MC Hammer broke. Now, when I say MC Hammer broke, that is real broke. When I say he is Michael Tyson, Mike Tyson broke, you get how vivid it is. Apparently, a motor car zitunzezo na bidia wotebi kwata. Gonna beg the question. So, was it the chick? Okay, we know the money was for the chick, but did you know that this guy actually doesn't have a day job? He doesn't have a day job because when they broke up the first time, I think they liquidated assets at the club that they owned. So I don't think they own the club anymore. Aside from that, he does nothing. So this whole wanting to show off in Kampala, driving fancy cars, living fancy lifestyles, guess what? Gali mabanja! Hey! The financial decisions people take in this country. Anyway, but it's rumor has it. Maybe he'll come out and clarify, but from the trusted sources I have, they saying, boo-boo, he broke. He's broke as they come. I'm like, I mean, my job is to give you lugambo. I don't even know how to justify it. Like, outside, inside. Yeah, still talking about all the people running broke and all the people selling off their assets. Guess what? Now, we all know SK Mbuga is still in jail. The chances of him rotting there are extremely high, extremely high. Now, from what I'm hearing, apparently Vivian has been doing a very good job of liquidating his assets too. She's been selling cars. She's been selling houses. I'm like, wait, babe, calm down. What happened? Do you think it's a personal directive from Lebu that baby, enosigenda kufira, you to be tunde muzije? What's going on? And what's funny, it's not just Vivian, the brother too. I'm like, never nae, so says izange namwe munonyereza nyo. Engeri jononyereza omuntu okutunda ekintu. Aish! Jesus is the Lord. I feel sorry for Mbuga though. I honestly do, because he, of all the rich people that are around, he had tried to do it in kind of a legitimate way, like have like a school here, like an ambulance here, like a... Where bit yoke te yali tabirina byonna byali mu nkola naye ngaagezaako tulimba aina chakola. But now Vivian is in Kampala. She has been slay queening. I keep seeing on Snapchat, oh, lunch with the friends, ooh this, ooh that. She is blasting. But in the meantime, they are selling off everything. We do hope it's to either get him out or she's not pulling a runner on him, because we know this chick's ain't loyal. We hope she is not pulling a runner. Ngagena bitunda ya vewa bwake. Agenda nonye her next mark, her next target. I mean, I love these girls. These girls is something. Ugh, they give me chills. These girls remind you that if you're just going to sit there and wait for a man to give you money, you got that wrong. You have to first invest in the man, get out all his money, and do a runner. Basically, it's a long con. I don't even know if the love is ever real. Does it have to be real? People are just looking at their money. Chiri Kampala, I keep telling you people. I keep telling you, chitokota si chibike. Ebi na yubi yabivu deye yo. Lebu njagala bi samu mango. I don't have time. All these people are very insignificant. As I'm buying time today, I am waiting for the significant ones. Yep. To come through. Chameleon. Naika midi mwagazachi. Mwagazachi kamuleke. I saw a story about him not being able to pay taxes for that VX that he drives. And he says, yo, first of all, y'all think I don't even got that money. I got money. He took photos of himself with dollars. I'm like, in 2019? God forgive me, but if you've been trying to have a kid, I've been trying to have a tasoma. You know? I don't know what I'm going to let Ivan Semwanga. Kati gwebo bireta muguno mwaka kumyaka jo. I just, validation is a bitch, people. Validation is going to kill people. Anyway, he came out, he says, now I can afford it. It's not like that. It's not even like that. I don't owe that kind of money. Blah, 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 blah. The usual back and forth with celebrities. Jeez. Anyway, I'm going to sign out now and say bye-bye. What I'm still waiting for, because Dora Mumaklesha has refused Jagamba Temumanyida, what I put up on my Facebook page about Poge paste. What is wrong with me? God damn. She claims and she's sticking to her guns. Whatever she posted on her page is her truth. Everybody has come up with their different assumptions. I've seen your feedback on YouTube. Loved it, loved it, loved it. Now, for all of you who don't understand why I was coming from an emotional point of view, y'all need to understand that I'm a parent and I see a bigger picture. And if you don't understand where my opinion and sentiment was coming from, it's okay. You can walk off a short bridge. It's my opinion after all. Yes, I'm waiting for her to come out. Oh, I'm waiting for the law and the DNA and all of that. And then Binyume. I'm just saying. That weekend is going to be long and it's going to be a blast. I'll catch you on the flip side. That's on Monday. For all of you who catch me every morning at 6:30 in the morning for Urban Today Live, guess what? I'll get you on Monday. For the scoop lovers, still I got you Monday. For now, though, at TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop at TinaFierce1. And, of course, Instagram is at TinaFierce1 with an H. I'll catch you again. Don't drink and drive. Do wear protection if necessary. It doesn't have to be here or here. It has to be everywhere, people. Anywhere. Hepatitis is a real killer. I'm out. Peace.